Ladies and gentlemen, this event is one fall. Introducing from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, Lee Scott. And his partner from Cocoa Beach, Florida, Tim Parker.
Jim Cornette will join me at ringside to provide color commentary. Well, Wahoo and I'll be back here next Saturday here on World Championship Wrestling here on PBS, the Superstation. I tell you something, I'm still a little upset at what happened in the Omni this past Sunday. I think Sting got a raw deal, but I think he can vindicate himself come Tuesday night with he and Flair versus Funk and Muda.
Well, I think it's going to be a great match. You know, you got two great athletes, and you got two great athletes on the other side. That makes for a tough, tough match.
I've asked Gordon Sully to join us, and he'll be joining me right before we go off the air here in our next segment. And he's been covering that situation involving Flair, Sting, Gary Hart, Funk, and Muda. And now Dick Slater since the beginning on WNN News. We're going to ask Gordon a prediction of who he predicts will win it all Tuesday night. Gordon Sully coming up next. Lee Scott. He's a tough kid. He's taking some of the most unbelievable beatings, but he's a guy that wants to be a star in the NWA. He's in there with two great ones in Eaton and Lee.
You know, lately, he should have a pilot's license. That's how much he flies around. Some of these guys put him up to the ceiling.
Oh, I know it, but he comes back for more. He got
he does.
Midnight Express, two-time World Tag Team Champions. I'm sure they're going to be watching along with the world Tuesday night to see the outcome of the Steiner's Freebird Tag Team Championship Showdown. Oh, they got him up. Atomic drop there. Well, they do some unusual things in Midnight Express.
They do. I'll say one thing. This Scott kid, once he puts a little weight on, never know.
I tell you what, Chief, it just doesn't seem right to say that Muda is the new television champion. It just doesn't seem right.
It doesn't, but he did it, and he is the champion.
And he's still undefeated.
Right. That could last for a long time, too, Jim Ross, with his ability.
Well, I said the stakes are even higher because of that this Tuesday night. Lee Scott slamming beautiful Bobby. What's Scott going to do?
I don't know. He hurt his back. Looks to me like he's trying to go up the turnbuckle.
Well, that's not the best place for a guy with a hurt back.
No,
Bobby Eaton.
Uh-oh.
Well, he'll come down pretty quick. A lot quicker than he went up. Chest first. I haven't ever seen that.
Chest first, yeah.
All right hand. Got clothesline right on the ring.
Right over the top, all the way to the floor.
Uh-oh, Sweet Stan has got Lee, Tim Parker, bed-o-matic time. Here it comes. Ooh. What's a high-risk, high-flying son of a gun.
High-risk move. If you don't hit right, that's it for you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the Midnight Express.
All right, fans, don't forget tomorrow night, 6:05 on the Man to Man. I'll be joined by Paul E. Dangerously. Right here, look at this, Chief. This is high risk for both men. Beautiful Bobby takes the chance and nails it. Indeed, they'll watch the outcome very closely of Tuesday night's World Tag Team Championship match. And I'll be back with the legendary Gordon Sully right after this timeout.
America's greatest wrestlers are coming to an arena near you. Saturday, September 16th, Kansas City, Missouri, Kemper Arena. Sting, Harley Race, and Ric Flair. And Lubbock, Texas, Memorial Civic Center, Wahoo McDaniel. The 15th, Corpus Christi, Texas, Memorial Coliseum, the Road Warriors. And St. Louis, Missouri, the Keel, Ric Flair and the Skyscrapers, and Muda. The 13th, Warner Robins, Georgia, the Civic Center, Sting and Dr. Death. The 12th, Fall Brawl, Clash of Champions, Columbia Coliseum, Columbia, South Carolina. Flair, Funk, Muda, Sting, and more. The 11th, Greenwood, South Carolina, the Civic Center, SST, the Freebirds, Midnight Express. Tomorrow night, Fort Pierce, Florida, St. Lucie Civic Center, the Express, the Road Warriors, and Lunatic, and Greensboro, North Carolina, the Coliseum, Ric Flair and Sting. And tonight, Palmetto, Florida, Manatee Civic Center, the Freebirds, SST, and Flying Brian, and Landover, Maryland, Cap Center, the Steiners, Terry Funk, the Great Buddha, America's greatest wrestlers, in action.
Get- Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to World Championship Wrestling. Jim Ross, along with Gordon Solie. And Gordon, you've been covering this situation involving Ric Flair and Sting versus Jerry Hart and his contingent of Terry Funk, Dick Slater, and a great Muda from the beginning. We're going to see some tape in a few moments, but I know you've got some thoughts on this Tuesday night's big event.
Well, I surely do, Jim. I'm very concerned, very frankly, about Ric Flair and Sting being tag team partners, but I think it might be a little easier to explain after we look at the film clip.
Ladies and gentlemen, 2 weeks ago, right here in Atlanta, the brawl ensued. Let's go and show you how Dick Slater received a broken arm from the Nature Boy.
He's using his right hand, much like Dick Slater did earlier. Atomic drop. Slater right outside from that momentum, like he was recoiled out there. And now Sting follows him out. He's in Slater's domain. Sting's shoulder.
Ring, Slater, bring it in the ring.
To the steel ring post. He didn't need to do that. He's in Slater's domain. Just exactly what you said. He shouldn't have taken it outside. He had Slater on the floor. He should have taken a breather inside, made Slater come to him. He went out and he played in the cat sandbox, and that's what happened.
Sting now will have to reach down. We have said it many times. Momentum has changed. Slater's corner of the ring. For the man from Venice Beach, California, as Dick Slater from Tampa, Florida, continues to work on this outstanding youngster, and the sleep hold, coupled with a fatigue factor. This may be too much for Sting to overcome.
And there's not a lot of wrestlers right now, Jim, in the NWA using the sleeper. I think that means that Sting is ill-prepared. Well, okay, I'm even wrong sometimes. I was going to say Sting may be ill-prepared to defend against it because he hasn't had it applied to him often, but he knew the counter. The standard counter, run your man right straight off of you, use his weight as momentum against him.
Sting now fights back. I tell you, he's got that great fighting spirit. He's formed a bond led by Nature Boy Ric Flair. That includes Flying Brian. That is those three guys, like the three great individuals. They love life. They live it to its fullest, but they live it the right way. And right here, Sting has got to continue to believe that he can win this match, to believe that he's got enough to overcome the veteran Dick Slater.
And I believe that he does believe that, Jim, because he is now he's waiting for Dick Slater to come back to him. He's using a wrestling hold rather than... He is staying with his specialty, and that's what he has to do to win this match.
Oh, real close there. Real close there in a pinning predicament. Slater just got that shoulder up. We talked earlier tonight about the mental toughness of the Cuban assassin. Dick Slater gives a new meaning to the word mental toughness. Well, he's not scared of much. He's scared of would scare the daylights out of most other people, I guarantee you that. And Sting right now, flat on his back, seeing a guy just like Flying Brian, like you said, with the personal endorsement of the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, and that is an unusual hold to be seen used against a friend of the Nature Boy. Certainly is. Maybe this is a subliminal message back to Flair that you're not the only one, Nature Boy, that can use the figure four, but no one can use it as well as the world champion.
That's true, and you hear the crowd now. The crowd, like we mentioned, with Flying Brian, the support, egging Sting on, urging him not to quit, urging him to give his utmost. That's exactly what he's doing. Somewhere or another, he escaped that figure four. I think he reversed and rolled the weight over and injured Slater's knee.
And right now, Sting waits in the ring. Slater at the disadvantage because the count is working against him.
You know, talking about subliminal, Gary Hart with the subliminal head, you've got to think that he's trying to send the message out to Ric Flair as well as Sting. Going back to that tag team match last September 12th, I've got to think there's something on Gary Hart's mind.
Besides no hair.
Yeah,
big right hand and no dandruff.
Wait a minute! It's a scooter bump! Oh no! Oh no!
It's a
Jimmy is still being pummeled and choked by that towel. Jimmy Hart with the branding iron in his hand.
Talking earlier in the week, and you said some, I think, some things that obviously I didn't think about. I don't think most of the fans would think about the consequences that Flair and Sting are both putting themselves in, especially the champion.
Well, precisely. Ric Flair, of course, the NWA World Heavyweight Champion, is a man of tremendous pride. I watched Ric when he wrestled for the University of Minnesota, and he was always a very, very proud competitor. Now, number one, in going into this tag team match, with a man that he's wrestled against in the past. They have not wrestled really as a tag team combination. They know each other's skills, but as a tag team, I don't know which one will want to be captain. I have a hunch it will be Flair. You also have the other aspect. You've got Gary Hart on the outside. You've got Muda. You've got Dick Slater, who's going to be around. And that cast, as far as I'm concerned, is a lethal weapon. I have to feel, Jim, that that Flair and Sting are going in there at a disadvantage. If I were to ask to be picked a winner here, I would really, really have to go along with Gary Hart's troops.
Ladies and gentlemen, there you hear from the Dean of Wrestling Broadcasters. Gordon Soley is going with Gary Hart. I think Gary Hart has got a plan. And if Flair and Sting can walk out of this Tuesday night's big event, 8:05 live as it happens here on the Superstation, I've got to say they'll be lucky men.
Well, I hope they pull the miracle off.
Ladies and gentlemen, for Gordon Soley and Chief Wahoo McDaniel, I'm Jim Ross saying thanks for being with us, and we'll see you tomorrow night at 6:05 on the NWA main event. Yeah!